Good morning, students. Today we will begin with one more new chapter, which is Principles of Inheritance and Variation. This chapter comes under the unit 2, that is Genetics and Evolution. Okay, this whole chapter, we will talk about the inheritance and variation. That is the reason the chapter name has been given as Principles of Inheritance and Variation. Okay, this comes under your unit 2. Unit 1 is reproduction in organisms, whereas unit 2 is genetics and evolution. This is the first chapter coming under unit 2, genetics and evolution. Okay, it's a very, very important chapter for your understanding also, and from the exam point of view. Okay, in this chapter, the chapter's name is Principles of Inheritance and Variation. There are certain principles for inheritance and variation. First, we will see what is inheritance and what is variation. Okay. Inheritance. Inheritance means we get certain characters from our parents. That is known as inheritance. Okay, generally we refer this term as heredity, right? We generally say, if anybody is commenting on you that you resemble your parents, or your hair is resembling your mother, your body, your skin color is resembling your father, then we generally say that it is heredity. Or if you are having certain character which is similar to your parents, then we generally comment that as heredity, right? So that character at that process is known as inheritance. The process by which characters are passed on from parents to offsprings is known as inheritance. Okay, what is inheritance? It is the process by which characters are passed on from the parents to the offsprings. In genetics, we generally use these terms offsprings. Okay, we generally use this term offsprings. Offsprings means children. Okay, however, in genetics, we generally do not use the term children. We always use the term offsprings. Okay, or progeny. Okay, offsprings can also be referred as progeny or child or children. Okay, usually what happens, from the parents, characters will be transferred to offsprings or progeny or a child. This process is known as inheritance. This is the reason children look similar to their parents, or children have certain characters similar to their parents. Okay, then what is variation? Variation is the degree by which the progeny differs from the parent. Okay, so variation is the degree by which the progeny differs from the parent. Now, what is the difference between inheritance and variation? If there is a parent and this parent has a child or offspring, this child will have certain characters which is similar to the parent. Okay, this child will have certain characters which are similar to the parent, then this is known as inheritance. Okay, in other cases, child will have certain characters which are not similar to that, to those of the parents. Okay, the child will have certain characters which actually differs from the parent characters. Okay, so this process is known as variation. Okay, even though we will have certain characters similar to our parents, we are not 100% resembling our parents, right? We have certain differences when compared to our parents. That difference is known as variation, whereas the similarity between a child and parent is known as inheritance. Okay, when we talk about genetics, we have to talk about both the terms inheritance and variation. Okay, we'll have to talk about both inheritance and variation, because there are certain characters that are transferred from a parent to progeny. There are certain characters which will not be, which will not transfer from the parent to progeny. Okay, so the characters that are passed on, that process is known as inheritance, and the degree by which the progeny differs from the parent is known as variation. Okay. Now, when we talk about genetics and evolution, especially when we talk about genetics, we have to refer to a person's name, Gregor Johann Mendel. Okay? Gregor Johann Mendel is the person who is known as father of genetics. Okay, Gregor Johann Mendel is referred as father of genetics because of his contributions towards this field of genetics. Okay, now what did he do? What did Gregor Johann Mendel did so that he is referred as father of genetics? Gregor Johann Mendel conducted hybridization experiments. Okay, Mendel, generally he is referred as Mendel. Mendel conducted hybridization experiments. Okay, hybridization experiments. What is hybridization experiments? Experiment in which a hybrid is formed. Okay, you know, hybrid means combination of two different characters forms a hybrid. Now, if you cross a plant 1 with plant 2 and you get a new plant 3, this plant has the combination of both the characters of plant 1 and plant 2. So, this plant is referred as a hybrid. Okay, this experiment is known as hybridization experiment. Okay, so Mendel, why he is referred as father of genetics? Because he conducted hybridization experiments for 7 long years. Okay, he conducted hybridization experiment for 7 years, and then he proposed principles of inheritance. He proposed certain principles of inheritance. Now, he conducted experiments for 7 consecutive years. Now, for his experiments, Mendel used one important plant, that is garden pea. Okay, scientific name is Physalum sativum. Okay, so for his experiments, for his hybridization experiments, Mendel used this particular plant known as garden pea plant. Scientific name is Physalum sativum. Okay, so he used garden pea and he conducted hybridization experiments for 7 years. Now, what is the reason he selected garden pea plants? The reason is garden pea plant has varieties of characters in it. Okay, it has varieties of characters. We will study it when we look into the working methodology of Mendel. Okay, now next topic we will study the methods involved by the methods followed by Mendel in order to propose this principles of inheritance or the methods used by Mendel in his genetics experiments. Okay, next topic is methods employed by Mendel. What are the different methods used by Mendel in order to conduct the hybridization experiments? The first method is selection of distinctive characters. The first method employed by Mendel is selection of distinctive characters. Okay, distinctive means a kind of different characters which only a particular person or a particular object will be having. So I have already mentioned that the plant used by Mendel for his experiment is garden pea plant or Pisum sativum. Why did he choose this particular garden pea plant is because this garden pea plant has distinctive characters or a special characters which are actually specific to this particular garden pea. Okay, so in order to conduct his hybridization experiments, the first method used by Mendel was selection of distinctive characters. Selection of distinctive characters means selection of distinctive characters in particular plant known as garden pea. The reason why he chose garden pea plant for his experiment was because garden pea has different distinctive characters. So garden pea plant has many distinctive characters, out of which 7 characters were chosen by Mendel. Okay, Mendel had chosen 7 characters of this particular garden pea plant. When I say 7 characters, 7 distinctive characters. Okay, 7 specific characters which are which are specific only to the garden pea plant. Now the speciality of these 7 characters were that they appeared in 2 contrasting forms. Okay, I'll give you the example so that you will get to know. First we will see which are those 7 characters selected by Mendel in garden pea plants. The first one is seed color. Okay, garden pea, the name itself indicates it's a pea plant. So the seed of this particular garden pea plant, what is the color of that particular seed? Now the next character is seed shape. Now it is garden pea. What is the shape of the seed of this particular garden pea plant? Next is flower color. What is the color of the flower of that particular plant? Then the next character, flower position. Which part of the garden pea plant are the flowers located or positioned? Pod shape. We all know garden pea plants, they generally produce pods inside which we will find the seeds. Okay, what is the shape of that particular pod? Then the next character, pod color. Okay, what is the color of that particular pod in which seeds are formed? The last character, that is the 7th character, is the stem height. Okay, the stem of this particular garden pea plants. Okay, I want all of you to recollect it again. Mendel, in order to conduct his hybridization experiments, that means crossing two plants in order to get a new plant which has the characters of these two parent plants. In order to conduct this hybridization experiments, Mendel had chosen garden pea plants. The reason why he had chosen garden pea plants is because garden pea plant has different, or we can say distinctive characters, several distinctive characters. Out of several distinctive characters, Mendel had chosen seven distinctive characters of this particular garden pea plant. Okay, distinctive characters means the characters which are specific only to this particular garden pea plant. Okay, the first character we chose was seed color. Now, you all know what is a garden pea, what is a Picin sativum. What is the seed color, generic seed color that you see in this particular garden pea plant? We generally see two types of seeds of garden pea. Okay, generally we will find a pod. Okay, we will see a pod. It will be like this or it will be like this. Okay, we will get pods from this particular garden pea plant. We generally open these pods to find the seeds inside, right? So the seeds will be present inside this particular pod. Okay, it will be attached to the particular pod. Okay, so what will be the seed color? Generally, if you look into the seed of a pea plant, the seeds will be either green in color and yellow in color. Okay, if you look into the seeds which will be present inside this pod, okay, the seeds will be either green in color or it will be yellow in color. So, the first character chosen by Mendel was if it is seed color, then the seed color appears in two different colors. Seed appears in two different colors. One is green, another one is yellow. Okay, these two characters are known as contrasting characters. Characters of a particular thing. Okay, now we are taking only reference of a seed color. It appears in two different types. So we call them as contrasting characters. This is also another reason why Mendel had chosen garden pea plant. Okay, Mendel had chosen garden pea plant because garden pea plant has several distinctive characters. And those characters also, these are the seven distinctive characters, those characters also appear in contrasting characters. Okay, appear in contrasting, we will say contrasting forms. These are the two contrasting forms of a particular character. Okay, this is one reason. There are seven distinctive characters, that is one reason Mendel had chosen this particular pea plant. And every character has two contrasting forms. Okay, now let's see seed shape. Generally, if you look into the seed of a garden pea plant, it is either this shape or sometimes it will be this shape. So if it is fully circular, we will say circle, we will say round. Okay, if it is fully circular, we will say round. If it is of this shape, we will say wrinkled. Okay, because it has wrinkles on it. So this is round, this is wrinkled. So these are the two contrasting forms of seed shape. Okay, when we talk about seed color, it is either green or yellow. If we talk about seed shape, the seed will be either round or sometimes it will be wrinkled. Then we will talk about flower color. Okay, flower color. If you have seen the garden pea plant, the garden pea plant has flowers which will be either white or it will be violet. Okay, the flowers will be white or it will be violet in color. Okay, flower position, in which particular part of the plant flower is located or flower is positioned. Let's draw a garden pea plant. Now, sometimes what happens is flower will be generally seen at the tip of the particular plant. Okay, the flower will be seen at the tip of the particular plant, or the flower will be seen in this part. Okay, it will be seen in this particular part. If the flower is seen in the tip of the plant, this position of the flower is known as terminal position. Terminal means at the tip or at the end. If the flower is seen at this particular part of the plant, then it is known as axial. Okay, so that is the flower position. Either it will be axial and it will be terminal. Okay, the flower, either it will be in the axial position or it will be in the terminal position. So that is the flower position, axial or terminal. Then if we look into the pod shape, okay, now if we look into the pod shape, these are the two different pods that will be seen in a garden pea plant. If you see these pods, few pods will be this shape or few pods will be this shape. Okay, so this pod is known as full pod. Okay, and this pod is known as constricted because it has certain constriction like this. Okay, so this pod is known as full pod and this particular pod is known as constricted pod. Okay, constricted pod because it has certain constrictions. Okay, then the pod color. The pod color also varies in garden pea. Sometimes it will be yellow in color and sometimes it will be green in color. Okay, so this is the pod color. Sometimes it will be, irrespective of whether it is full or constricted, it could be yellow in color or green in color. Then if we talk about stem height, this is the last character that we will refer in this particular topic. Okay, either the plant will be having tall stem or the plant will be having dwarf stem. Okay, tall and short. Short we refer as dwarf. Okay, so these are the seven characters, selection of distinctive characters. So in his experiment, Mendel employed certain methods. The first method is selection of distinctive characters. That means selection of certain characters which are specific to that particular plant. Now, garden pea plant has several characters, out of which seven characters were chosen by Mendel. The first character was seed color, then seed shape, flower color, flower position, pod shape, pod color, and stem height were the seven characters chosen by Mendel. Why he had chosen these seven characters? Because all the seven characters exist in two contrasting forms. Okay, the seed color, it could be either green and it could be, or it could be yellow. Seed shape, it could be round or wrinkled. Flower color, white or violet. Flower position, axial or terminal. Pod shape, full or constricted. Pod color, yellow and it could be green also. Stem height, either the plant is tall or the plant is dwarf. Okay, so these were the different characters chosen by Mendel. And this is the first method employed by Mendel for his hybridization experiments. Then we will discuss about the second method used by Mendel second method is selection of true breeding varieties. The second method used by Mendel was selection of true breeding varieties. Now he has chosen garden pea plants with 7 distinctive characters. Okay, now next step in his experiment was to select true breeding varieties. True breeding varieties means the plants which have undergone self-pollination for many number of years. Okay, so that is the meaning of true breeding varieties. True breeding varieties means the plants which usually undergo self-pollination and the plants which do not undergo cross-pollination. Okay, in a simple term, true breeding varieties are those which will undergo self-pollination for many number of years. They will never undergo cross-pollination. That means there is a bisexual flower, there is a pistil there is a stamen there, the pollen grains are released from the anther, it will sit on the stigma of the same flower. This is self-pollination. We have studied in detail what is pollination. So the plants usually which undergoes this type of pollination or self-pollination are known as true breeding varieties. Okay, now true breeding varieties has certain specification also. Now imagine there is a parent plant. There is a parent plant. This plant will produce a progeny or another plant or an offspring. In case of plants also, we will consider parent plant and a progeny or offspring. A parent plant has produced a progeny plant. Now, we will call them true breeding varieties only when the progeny, or we will also use the term offsprings, when the offsprings have the same characters as that of the parent. Okay, we will call this particular plant a true breeding varieties if this particular plant has the same characters as that of his parent. When, in which scenario this will happen, that the characters which are present in the parent plant will be directly transferred to the progeny? Only when this plant has undergone self-pollination and has never undergone a cross-pollination. Okay, now if this progeny forms the generation 3, okay, now this acts as a parent, it will produce a progeny. This progeny should, the characters of this particular progeny or offspring should match the characters of this parent and this parent. Then this progeny will be considered as a true breeding varieties. Choosing these types of plants were the second step of Mendel. Okay, selection of true breeding varieties. The plants, selecting those offsprings whose characters match exactly with their parent characters. This is possible only if the parent plant from which the progeny has been produced, these parent plants should have undergone self-pollination for number of years. Okay, or continuous self-pollination. They shouldn't have undergone a cross-pollination. Selecting these types of plants were Mendel's second method. Okay, selection of true breeding varieties. True breeding varieties means where the characters of the offspring will match the characters of the parent. This is possible only when the parent has undergone self-pollination and not cross-pollination. If another progeny is produced from this particular progeny, this acts as a parent, and this progeny will have the characters matching with this parent as well as this parent. Okay, then they are known as true breeding varieties. Mendel had to choose this type of true breeding varieties because he did not want any confusion or any mixture of combinations. Okay, so this is the second step used by Mendel. The third step used by Mendel is controlled fertilization. Now, which plant did Mendel choose for his experiments? Garden pea. Garden pea is a bisexual flower. That means it has both male and female reproductive organs inside a single flower. When a flower is bisexual, generally it undergoes self-pollination. The pollen grains will come from the anther and it will it will sit on the stigma of the same flower, then the pollination and the fertilization happens. We have studied them in detail. Okay, Mendel did not want this to happen. Okay, Mendel wanted to choose the true breeding varieties. After choosing the true breeding varieties, Mendel did not want self-pollination to happen in that particular plant. Why? Because Mendel wanted to cross the two plants according to his wish. Right? Mendel did not want the plant to undergo self-pollination naturally. He did not want the self-pollination to happen because Mendel wanted to carry out cross-pollination. Okay? The Mendel wanted to carry out cross-pollination. However, point to be noted here is that Mendel chosen true breeding varieties. That means the plant which has undergone self-pollination for continuously. However, once he has chosen those particular plants, he did not want the plants to undergo self-pollination. Okay, what is generally done if the plants should not undergo self-pollination? Emasculation, right? Emasculation is in a flower, if the female reproductive part and the male reproductive part, this is anther, this is stigma, if they are close, which is the case in garden pea, both of them are close, when the pollen grains are released from this particular anther, generally it will go and sit on the stigma and the pollination will take place. Mendel did not want this to happen because he wanted to cross this particular plant with his desired plant. So he cut this particular stamen from this particular flower. So that is known as emasculation. We have already studied hybridization techniques. Okay, in that I have told you that the process of cutting of anther from a bisexual flower is known as emasculation. He has cut the anthers so that no pollen grains will come from this particular anther and it will pollinate the, pollination happens here. Okay, so this is what is controlled fertilization. That means Mendel did not want self-pollination to happen, whereas Mendel wanted to bring anther, Mendel wanted to bring pollen grains from some other flower to this particular flower. Okay, Mendel wanted to bring according to his wish. He was doing hybridization experiments. That means he was crossing two parent plants to get a hybrid plant. Okay, he will choose who are the parent plants. Now, if he thinks this is the parent plant 1, this is the parent plant 2, and he will not allow the self-pollination to happen here. He will cut the anther, emasculation. Then this is parent 1. Okay, he will get the pollen grains from parent 2. He will add it on the stigma of this particular flower. Then the pollination will happen. Then fertilization. Right? The male gamete which is present inside the pollen grain will come and fertilize the egg which is present inside the ovule. We have studied the whole process of fertilization, right? So, since fertilization was controlled by Mendel, it was known as controlled fertilization. He did not want the self-pollination to happen. He wanted cross-pollination to happen. So, in order for the cross pollination to happen, he cut the anthers from a bisexual garden pea flower, and he brought the pollen grains of his own choice, and he conducted cross pollination. And once the cross pollination was done, fertilization happened. Since the fertilization was controlled by Mendel, it is known as controlled fertilization. This is the third step involved by or employed by Mendel in order to conduct his hybridization experiments on garden pea or Pisum sativum. The last step or the last method used by Mendel was pedigree analysis. Pedigree analysis means Mendel kept accurate records or the exact records of all his experiments or all the methods used by him in his experiments. Okay, Mendel kept all the records of his experiments properly. First time in the history of biology, mathematical calculation and statistical analysis first time in the history of biology, mathematics and statistical analysis was used by Mendel. Okay, Mendel was the first person to use mathematics and statistical calculation for his bring about the result of his hybridization experiments. So these are the different methods employed by Mendel. In this chapter, we have to study what is inheritance. Inheritance is a process by which characters are transferred from the parent to the progeny. We generally say it as heredity. Then variation. Variation is a degree by which a progeny differs from its parent. And then Gregor Johann Mendel is referred as father of genetics. Why he is referred as father of genetics? He conducted hybridization experiment for 7 years using the plant Pisum sativum. Why and what are the methods used by Mendel for his experiments? First is selection of distinctive characters. Okay, for this he used garden pea plant, and he selected 7 different characters of garden pea plants: seed color, seed shape, pod color, pod shape, flower color, flower position and stem height. Okay, and why he has chosen, I had chosen those 7 characters, because all of them existed 2 contrasting forms. Then selection of true breeding varieties, the organism who will undergo or the plant who will undergo continuous self-pollination, and the characters of the progeny matches with the characters of the parent. Then controlled fertilization. He did not want the pollination to happen naturally. Mendel wanted to carry out the pollination so that he can get the hybrid plants. So he usually cuts the stamen of a particular bisexual flower, and he brings the pollen grains from the desired plant. So that is known as controlled fertilization. Pedigree analysis means keeping, analyzing your work properly and keeping all the records. Here in case of Mendel, he used mathematics and statistical analysis for his results. Okay, in the next topic, we will study how Mendel actually carried out hybridization experiment. Actually, he conducted a monohybrid cross, a dihybrid cross. After these crosses, he proposed certain laws which are generally known as principles of inheritance. Okay, like law of dominance, law of segregation of gametes, law of independent assortment. We will study all these laws one by one when we go to the respective topics. In our next class, we will study how Mendel carried out monohybrid cross and what were the laws proposed by Mendel after carrying out monohybrid cross. Okay.